his opinion. He thinks the president will resign. Ultimately, Schwartz spent nearly a year with Trump ghostwriting the art of the deal. He tweeted this, quote, "The circle is closing at blinding speed. Trump is going to resign and declare victory before Mueller and Congress leave him no choice. Trump's presidency is effectively over," he said. "Would be amazed if he survives till end of the year. More likely resigns by fall, if not sooner." Tony Schwartz joins me now. So, Tony, I'm wondering what, I mean, you and I have talked about this before. You've thought this maybe for a long time. What makes you feel this so strongly now?
Well, I think the snowball is beginning to gather momentum as it comes down the mountain. And it reminds me a lot of Watergate in the last days of Nixon. When the tide turns, it really turns, and that's what's happened here. You look at the range of things that have happened, most notably his response to the events in Virginia this last week, and what he's gone back and forth saying to Kim Jong-un about North Korea, and you've got he's put himself in an isolated, no-win position. The level of his self-destructiveness is staggering. But what he's done is he's pushed away all the potential allies, and they were beginning to diminish in number anyway. But he's now pushed away business people, CEOs. He's now pushed away Bannon. You see Bannon playing politics with his own boss. He's pushed away, a good percentage of the Congress, even in his own party. So where's the potential to survive? And then sitting in the background on this, Anderson, of course, is Mueller's continuing investigation into Russia. And look, this is not a Boy Scout, Donald Trump. Never was part of the Boy Scouts. He's been lying. It's not he started lying when he became president or when he started running for president. This is a man who's been deceitful and manipulative for 50 years plus. So what's going to get uncovered by an investigation that really looks into every corner is almost incalculable. But my belief about why he'll resign is that, go ahead.
Well, but I mean, for a president who hates losers, talks about losers as if losing something is the worst thing imaginable, if he left the presidency before his term, wouldn't he be considered a loser, and wouldn't that be intolerable? Or are you saying he's going to try to come up with some way to make, as Sarah Palin attempted to do, quitting seem like working harder or being a victory?
Yeah, there's no question he's going to do that, because he paints even the most disastrous of things he does, including what he said about the events in Virginia over the past week, as evidence of his own brilliance. So what he's going to do is he's going to blame it on the Democrats. He's going to actually blame it on the Republicans. He's going to blame it on anybody he can. And he's going to say that he did everything he could to save America. And by the way, I don't want to write his talk for him, his resignation speech. But he is going to try his very best to paint this as his own victory, and he's the ultimate victim, but he did everything he could.
And all the time you spent with
him. And he's going to do it, of course, to stay out of prison. That's why he's going to do it.
All the time you spent with him, did he ever express any sort of moral equivalence between, racists and those who counter them? I mean, were you surprised by the remarks that he made unscripted, without a teleprompter on Tuesday?
Look, it's hard not to be surprised by any human being who says the kind of unbelievably crazy things he said. It's not even moral equivalence. Believe me, the word moral never came up during the 18 months that I spent with Donald Trump. That was not part of his vocabulary. It was, how do I do whatever is best for me, or what I perceive is best for me, and how do I get over on everybody else? The idea of moral equivalence, I guarantee you that phrase is no more than a few days old in Donald Trump's brain.
Tony Schwartz, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Coming up, we're going to hear from the rabbi in Charlottesville who was inside.